Are you tired of taking blurred, smudgy selfies? Well then, Xiaomi seems to think they have a solution for you with the 17 Pro lineup of devices. These integrate a display in the back of a smartphone to be able to frame yourself up properly and use the main shooters from the back that are much better in terms of quality than the front. The Xiaomi 17 lineup is actually a pretty good encapsulation of how things differ from Chinese phone makers to Western phone makers. So let's take this chance to look at what Xiaomi has announced in September 2025, as well as how the Chinese smartphone market has evolved in the past 2 years. Starting off with the battery, these phones are using a new type of battery chemistry that I've talked about in the past called silicon carbon batteries. These are slightly more efficient batteries. That means that you can pack in a bigger battery for the same size of phone. As a result, the Xiaomi 17 Pro Max has a battery size that's 30% bigger than the iPhone 17 Pro Max. You'll notice the very similar naming scheme, but the Xiaomi 17 lineup also has faster charging. While these quirks are enough to set it apart from phones from Apple or Samsung, this quirkiness is a feature of the Chinese smartphone market. So you're seeing smartphones that fold 3 times, you're seeing smartphones that have these giant telephoto lens attachments, and all of these kind of quirky features on top of very solid smartphones. That comes from the very strong competition that you have in the Chinese market. This is the largest smartphone market in the world. When I started Tech Asia 2 years ago, I covered the Oppo Find N2, I believe, which was only available for sale in mainland China. That meant that the coolest folding phones or even applications of battery and screen technologies were limited to China-only release. This is changing with lots of flagship products like Huawei's Mate XT, the tri-folding phone, becoming available in overseas markets. If you look at Xiaomi's MIUI user base, they have 700 million monthly active users as of 2024. 500 million of these users are based outside of China. And those markets are Southeast Asia, Southern Asia, but increasingly Europe and the US as well. So you would assume that the Xiaomi 17 lineup would be available in the West, but no. So this comes with a caveat that typically these releases come a few months after the Chinese release because the demand is so huge in the Chinese market that it allows them to ramp up production in mainland where the costs are lower, you don't have tariffs. So it's better for these companies to start out rolling out their products first in mainland and then getting into international markets. We're seeing this with lots of other companies. So Huawei has greatly expanded in Europe, especially with its folding phones. This isn't just happening for smartphones. So car makers and other electronics manufacturers are starting to expand overseas. I think Xiaomi is a very good case study for us to understand how these Chinese brands are expanding into overseas markets. So the day before the Chinese event, there was an event held in Munich to announce Xiaomi was selling washing machines, fridges, and AC units to the international markets. This indicates to me that more and more Chinese companies are focusing on localizing their products in international markets while still keeping a very high focus on gimmicks and features that set them apart from the competition in Chinese markets. I'm quite excited to see how that competition shakes up incumbents and forces them to innovate, as well as how it impacts the markets in the future. For the next little while at least, Xiaomi's 17 lineup will join the relatively small rank of China-exclusive smartphones. I believe the only other ones that are still like flagship main smartphones but China-exclusive are the Huawei Pura X, as well as the Vivo X200 Ultra that has this giant telephoto lens. Please do chime in if you know any other flagships that are still China-exclusive, but I think that'll be my last sign-off for Tech Asia. It's been an absolute honor and a pleasure to host Tech Asia for those of you that have been watching me. If I'm able to see you somewhere else, I'll see you there. And until next time, take care.